today's episode of I Make Cool Shit, I'm going to show you how to repurpose a broken controller into a piece of art. Public service announcement, all controllers used in production were ethically sourced from broken bins. So what I gotta do now is clean all the crud out of there. Now it comes to the board. This is where all the magic happens, and we're gonna take all this apart. Solder wick. Take this solder wick, and I'm going to use it. When you heat it up, it sucks the solder into the copper and allows you to remove components off of circuit boards. After a quick clean with soap and water, we're ready to go. Just the angels enjoying my work. Now on to the display. The plan for this, we're going to do a black background, and to throw the color off a little on the display, we're going to paint this red. So I got this Rust-Oleum. Spray adhesive. You can use general purpose, it's just what I have lying around. I'll coat this. Roll with it. Other there's technically two sides. You want to use the fluffy side. Do is be mindful of the orientation. So if you're going to mount it this way or this way, in our case we're going to mount it this way, take the trim ring that we painted and we set it over here, and we see this is our work area that we have to make, and we can start laying things out how we want them. Design on the front here, maybe we can incorporate that into the back of this. Gray. I think. Sweep that in right here. About right. There we go. That'll look a lot better. So on the back we have all these nubbies sticking up. We're gonna flatten those off. Alcohol pad. Just clean the stuff I missed inside here too. Kids are gross. I know this because I used to be one. We have to come up with our layout, how we want the final product to look. I'll need a glue gun. A little nubby on the back here. We're gonna cut that off. That's better. Symmetrical, something like that. So now we're gonna wait for that to warm up and then glue that all in. One of the things I like is my attention to detail. So I'm gonna take this piece of aluminum tape, hide it behind me, just like that. I think it looks better. Kinda cool. Draws the attention. Exactly perfect. About 3 inches. What I'm going to do is I'm going to center the top one and center the back. And line everything up in between it. I think that'll be the easiest way to go about this. All those nubbies we cut off, and just put the glue right on there. Get it in the four corners. Symmetrical things. We're gonna try to keep this design. Mount this up a little bit. I'll show you why later. This isn't flat, so we'll just cover it with that. You can't even tell. Use too much glue? Absolutely. Do I care? Not really. Now this is a museum piece, so we want to include all the pieces. These little screws, we're going to find a way to put those in too. Just the idea. Ow. Style display, so we want to show all the components of this cord. So this is a little bit difficult part. This is held in with points here and here. So what you want to do is you want to take a sharp pointy object, run it on through. Let's This and find a way to display these three components somewhere on here. And leave a little extra because we don't know what we're going to need it for. So what I like to do is maybe put that around there. Wires just the way they are. Find the nicer side. Let's do this side. Strippers. Show all the wires in there. To do is put some tape, doesn't matter what kind, just what I have lying around. Guess we're gonna get all the little dust bunnies off. We're all just putting it all together. Go. So we're in here. We can can take this a step further. Got this old label maker from the 80s, probably older. Turn the wheel to what you want it to say.